The traditional style, I can say, centers around the rituals of the year. So most of the practitioners used to work in the traditional style with traditional subjects. I too painted like them for a decade. When I became a little more, I can say, aware of what I practiced, I was bored. I was really bored with what I was doing. I was bored. I wanted to see a much bigger world of art and art practitioner. So I wanted to break out of this, this thing called Madhubani painting, see a bigger world. I went to Baroda and studied fine arts for 5 years. But I can say very honestly, I did not learn much because the art I saw there, I was not prepared to understand at all. But the kind of fraternity I saw, which I loved, all the time there is a bustling crowd. People are very fun-loving, very open to each other, talking of a lot of things which I could have never imagined here. So a big world opened up before me. I loved being in Baroda. So when I came back, the question was what I should do now. I cannot switch over to the other style. It's out of the question. So I thought, why don't I return to the same roots which I had known so much, so well, so clearly. Then again, I had a question. The way I painted, I felt I was not satisfied, not at all. I wanted to paint like Ganga Devi, the master artist. I was besotted by her line, her austere divine line. So I thought I should develop the same kind of life, same kind of line, same powerful line. So it just took me 10 years to understand that medium. That's why I tell you, to me, this art became a particular, a distinct school of painting, distinct style of painting, because I took a different approach to understand it. I did not practice it like everyone. I thought I should first understand the medium, what is its real power. Its real power lies in the line. So in 10 years, I drew things, extensively, exhaustively. I did not know what I did. I just drew things all the time. I would choose a paper and draw things and fill them up with fine lines. By the time it was 2000, I thought I have done enough. Now I begin to develop an understanding of my own line. I have done a lot of series like Krishna series, Buddha series, Kali series, and then I have done very recently the Umbrella series, the rain experience. The beautiful thing about the Umbrella series was that I went to visit NID in Gandhinagar. As we came out of the faculty and I was just on the road, I saw a huge expanse of blue and grey right in front of me. Amazing. I couldn't believe the nature is so bountiful, so full. And then, a drizzle began, a very drizzle, a small drizzle began. It was very lyrical. And so, as we have covered just a few kilometers, it became a torrent lashing on my left. Amazing experience till I reached the Ahmedabad station. Amazing. Terrific. I would love to be, lashed by the rain in the same way once in every year in my life. It's wonderful. painting the Gujarat scenery was really my education. What happens in our country is one thing, and what somebody has in mind for the same value is very, very confusing, is not clear, is very ambiguous, is very different, that you say one thing and you practice one thing. And it really is the way of politics, I think. This is what I learned. And the other thing I learned from the series is that one should not choose a god for one's political goal or for any goal, because God is very universal. It is not that Ram was very happy when Muslims were butchered. I'm sure Ram won't be. The kind of Ram I have known from childhood, I'm sure must be crying inside his heart when innocent Muslim children were butchered like anything. I can't believe. But for the first time, I got an insight into politics. But I could not believe these guys, because they are always after an image and they are very much propagandists. They're not the real people. They can't be real. If you are a real person, why would you coin up an image which has nothing to do with the real philosophy? In the very real sense, we have to evolve, become refined to reach a very higher stage. That is the core meaning of Hinduism. But they have coined up a new definition of Hinduism, which is called New Hindutva, which is their own creation, which is not good for all of us, which they do just for the vote. Is this the philosophy of Hinduism? No, this can't be. I don't think so. If you have really, transcended everything and merged with the universe and has become a universal soul, a universal phenomena, how would you be governed by these petty prejudices and divisions and discriminations? Then you are not a god. There are a lot of series which I love most, and the one which gave me a very, I can say, special feeling of a relationship with my own medium was the Krishna series. And something very, I can say, strange happened to me. Like I started receiving signals about the series. It was in 2007. I felt now I should quit the job and concentrate on my own art, because I was receiving those signals inside my heart. I should paint. I should return to my own art, to my own passion. Then I started painting the Krishna series. Like I love dance or theater or performances a lot. So I was very much fascinated by these things. So I just draw a head of Krishna on the paper and just started contemplating it for 3-4 hours. I felt I have not existed in those 4 hours. I was lost. I don't know where I was like that. I was almost lost. Then suddenly I would wake up and try to, as if somebody is just, making me do that, telling me, go and draw the crown, do the hair, do the eye like that. So this experience, which is a very different experience, has happened to me in 2008. It's like I used to see it very frequently in those periods when I painted. I felt I didn't exist. I felt I numbed completely. I don't exist at all. Maybe I was drawn in a state of vacuum for hours and hours. I felt nothing exists outside me. I don't know anybody. As if I got simply, drawn in a state of, emptiness. And that state was a wonderful experience. I always feel I am very calm all the time. So it's a wonderful experience.